may think of psychological disorders like depression and anxiety as uniquely human problems. What you may not know is that many animals suffer from depression and anxiety. For instance, studies found psychological disorders in 45 different mammalian species. Birds are known to pluck their feathers, and dogs are known to chase their tail and overprey. Flint is a chimpanzee in captivity. He was diagnosed with depression. You're probably thinking, oh, it's because he's in captivity, but it's actually because his mother, Flint, died. He stopped eating, stared off into space, and laid right where she laid and died. Something very sad, but also very true, is that animals can commit suicide. But don't go home thinking your pet will do it. Elephants, rats, and dolphins are all known to commit suicide. Elephants are known to step on the trunk and suffocate themselves. But you can prevent these happenings by paying attention to the signs. Something that is very frequent is OCD in cats. Grooming, meowing, and pacing are all behaviors that indicate that they are anxious or in pain. Bored horses can become a danger to themselves because they can bite through stalls, pacing, and kicking the walls. My dog has recently been chewing on her back right foot to the point where it's bleeding, but we took her to our vet and it is due to allergies. Now she's on medicine. When you think of pigs, what's the first thing you think of? I think of fat, but pigs can actually become anorexic. They are known to starve themselves because of stress. This is actually becoming so common that they have given it a name, Thinso syndrome. But even your pets at home could have a mental disorder. Many dogs suffer from separation anxiety. I relate to this because I used to have separation anxiety because my cousins lost their mom at a very young age, and I thought I was the one who had to protect my mom, and if I wasn't there, I could lose her. Mental disorders does not have to restrain your animal. By paying close attention to your animal, you can save them because mental illness does not have to be perpetual. For example, Michael Vicks forced 51 pit bulls to fight in his backyard. Two died of injury, and one was deemed too emotionally and physically damaged to be saved, but 48 became the first of dozens to be rehabilitated. These dogs use their second chance to become a part of families, emotional support dogs, and canine ambassadors. One was even a therapy dog and was named the ASPCA Dog of the Year, meaning American Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. If you notice your animal having these signs, you can take them to your local vet to get them help instead of having a self-diagnosis. Emotional support animals are very important to us, but we may be just as important.